Well, it seems today with 10-year Treasury futures that well-worn mixture of risks continue to keep us in check. 53 days away from the election, we have a easy policy Fed with the bias towards becoming even more accommodative towards the end of the year. We have hopes and data points with regards to any type of vaccine with COVID-19, et cetera, et cetera. So all that to say, this morning's micro market maybe had a little bit of some bearish factors given yesterday's bounce back in risk assets, given 10-year supply today, and also another day of heavy issuance in the corporate world. So all that to say, today's trading was a well-defined range, yet it was fairly volatile. Overseas, we had the ECB, didn't say anything out of the ordinary, anything really to change the context, except that German bonds did close at a one-week high of -42.9, just about 43 bips. On our shores, with weekly jobless claims slightly higher than last week, PPI, at least core, beat ever so slightly. So if anything else, it was neutral to bullish to the dollar. Didn't do a whole lot to 10-year Treasury futures today. That said, until there's some overarching reason for us to break out of this 50 to 79 basis point range that we have seen, 50 bips being the low, 79 bips being the high, technicals definitely coming into focus. When you look at most technicals, the momentum continues to be bullish and does have room to extend. That said, I'm not sure too many traders are willing to bet on that so far. On the resistance side, you see 60.2 being very meaningful, followed by that psychologically important 50 basis points. And then lastly, that record low of 31 basis points would be in sight. On the other hand, a bearish retracement to get us in that 75 to 85 range would be 95.6, and then that psychologically important 1%. Most traders believe if we do see the type of retracement, it's going to be really hard to get short treasuries given the amount of buying there will be on the way up as yields go higher.